So when we talk about batch resizing images, we're usually talking about taking a collection of images and resizing them all to be the same size or scale them down the same amount. But sometimes you're doing kind of the opposite. You're taking a single image and you want to produce multiple versions of it. App developers have to do this all the time to produce the icons in their apps. Sometimes you need to do it for other purposes as well, for screenshots and different things in projects. So let's look at an example of how to do it. But instead of using Automator or some batch processing tool inside of an image editing app like Photoshop or something, we'll use the terminal and create a shell script. And a shell script is something that runs in the terminal that's more than one line. And it's a little program. So here I've got in a folder a test image and I've got my script, which is in a text file that I can open up in TextEdit. So here it is. It's pretty simple. When you write a shell script in TextEdit, you start it off with the line that's the pound symbol or hash symbol, exclamation point, and then /bin/bash. This says that when this file is run as an executable, it should be run using the bash shell, which is usually what you type commands in using the terminal. Then I set a variable, just two letters FN I use for the variable, and I set it to test image, which is the name of the file. In this case it's testimage.jpg. Now here's the tricky part. This is the part that you just can't do as a regular terminal command. I'm going to loop and go through a series of sizes. So I'm going to use 4 and then another variable called size in and then a whole series of numbers 29, 40, 48, 50, all the way up to 1024. These are going to be the sizes for the images I'm going to generate. They happen to be the sizes you need when you create an app icon if you're an app developer. Then after 4 you need to follow it up with do and done. And between them you have the command. And the command is going to run the SIPS command, which is something built in the terminal that you can use to resize images. You can just do it as a single line using a similar format just to process an image from one size to another. -z means we want to resize it, and then the size is going to take the value of the variable size. I put the dollar sign in front of it to indicate that. So the first time it runs, this will be a 29. The second time it'll be a 40, etc. Then with quotes around it, we're going to use the value of the variable fn, so test image, and we put these little brackets around it to make it clear what the variable is. We don't need to do that here because we've got spaces around size. Now we do --out. So we're going to output it not as the same file name, not replacing the file, but we're going to use a different file name, which is going to be the thing in between the quotes here, the same name, so test image, but also tag on the variable size. So in other words, instead of testimage.jpg, we'll end up with testimage29.jpg. And then it's going to loop and it'll do the same thing, but size is going to be 40. So you end up taking the image, resizing it to a 40 by 40. And it's a square image in this case, so it makes it really easy. And then you end up with a testimage40.jpg. And it will do 48 all the way to 1024. So we'll close this. And how do we run it? Well, we're going to run it by launching terminal. And first thing we need to do is we need to get into this directory here. So we'll do cd, change directory. And I'm going to drag the folder here just as a quick way to type that name. So now we should be in there. I can check by using list directory, ls. And we can see there's processImage.txt and testImage.jpg. So we are in the right place. Now to run this, I'm going to do --/, which is just a good way to force it to, instead of accessing the file, to actually run the file. And we'll do processImage.txt. Now, a lot of people like to rename the file .sh instead of .txt. But it really doesn't matter. It's going to run it no matter what the extension is. And I'll hit return. And you can see it does a whole bunch of processing outputs for each time through the loop exactly what it's doing. And I look now at the directory and I can see that is now filled up with files that are that size. So this was a 1024 by 1024. Actually, this was a smaller or a larger image, 4,000 by 3,000. So this is now 1024 by 768. So the maximum width was 1024. And then the other dimension, the height, follows suit. And you have that all the way down to this one, the 29 by 21. So in the case of doing app icons, of course, these are square images, like I mentioned before, that you would start off with a 1024 by 1024, and you would get a repeat of that, and then one at 512 by 512, one at 180 by 180, all the way down to 29 by 29. But since this is a non-square image, 4,000 by 3,000, you'll just get the maximum dimension being that. So this is an easy way to do it, and the great thing about it is, for doing things like app icons and things, it's very common to change that image and then want to regenerate all of these. So here you could just delete them, or I believe it just will overwrite the image if I would run it again, and I could have it very easily in Terminal here go ahead and recreate all those little images from this one big one.